striking superiority coming from Chan Rotana. Chan Rotana's had over 200 Kumkumai matches. Gustavo Velarde's had over 300 wrestling matches. There's a lot of experience inside the circle right now.
Such diversity amongst our many viewers around the world for one championship. An amazing viewership we have. A big hello to Usman Kamar watching on YouTube from Canada. Tweets and Facebook messages, YouTube messages on the Instagram, all coming through from fans all over the world. Natalia wants to hug it out. Gustavo Bernard will have none of that. Third and final round. That has to be the time. Will the Kumkumai specialist turn up the striking now? Fake downstairs from Barad. There's a nice front kick from Rotana. Then switch it to a roundhouse kick. Looking punches at the power over the top of Gustavo Barad. So, front kick to a roundhouse kick. Seems to be the bread and butter combination work for Chan Rotana. The push kick off the lead foot, the roundhouse kick off the back foot. As he goes toe to toe with Barad. Barad onto the Barad overhand left. Front kick. Double front kick. Jab two. Barad driving the number two. That being the right hand. Box up for a single return. And just shuts it off.
Good takedown defense from Rotana so far. He's thrown a lot of volume with these kicks. But Barad's doing a good job of defending these kicks as well. The aggression is definitely on show from Chan Rotana as one of those body kicks sneaks through the guard.
Gustavo Barad has so many fans around the world following his final championship table. Last time out, he lost a very close decision to Tatsumitsu Wada. Fans have been doing this all night, but they're not looking forward to the Cuban, and here he is. Locks onto a single leg, there's an overhand left, but for a second bite of it, putting connect, popping right hand there from Rotana, and they break off. Jab to Rotana, full extension. You see though, Barad is breathing heavy here in the third. This is the chance Rotana needs. Looks for a driving takedown, Barad, not quite what he wanted. Maybe he's attacked the back door of Rotana. Rotana stands back up. Barad wants him down the canvas.
Beautiful job by Rotana to work his way back up. Barad was able to get him down, but Rotana popped right back up now. He's got to try to dig some underhooks. He's got to try to get his arms underneath the arms of Barad so he can pry him up just like that. Good job by Rotana. Now he's got to try to turn the corner. Yep, gets away. You can see Barad breathing real heavy. This could be Rotana's opportunity.
The Cuban has slowed down. This is where Rotana needs to go hell for mother.
You see the mouthpiece just kind of dangling out there from Barad. Dangerous to do.
Barad would have got this single leg down very quickly in the opening round. Took a lot longer here in the third. Rotana glances towards his corner across the circle. They want their man to get back up. They know that Barad is exposed on the feet because he is tired. And Barad will just grind him on the ground, but shave the seconds off the clock with 1:50 remaining.
Your championship superstar featherweight Poe Tall screaming advice at his combatant Chan Rotana to work his way back up to his feet, and Chan Rotana does just that as Barad is tenacious for that takedown. He's got 90 seconds left. Good job, Rotana. Push that head away. Let's see if he can keep it up.
And now we're back to the striking range for Chan Rotana, the Kumkumai stylist. Launches the right hand. There's a wild uppercut. There's another one from Rotana. Needs more accuracy. So to the left hand. Both big swing now. And it's very hard hitting punching from Gustavo Barad. Tucks around. People are rich behind. Each a right hand Barad. He may be right for the beginning now. Gustavo Barad. And Rotana finished the round. The Cubans can't even stand still. Here come the elbows from Chan Rotana. Rotana got left here. No point.
Chan Rotana just lit him up on the